Oh my gosh. It is different every time. This time, this last time, we haven't toured, like we toured last year briefly, I think it was 3 weeks. So this is, it's very different. This is my first tour actually. It's my first tour without my mom. So it's a tough one. It sucks. Cancer sucks. Yeah, I lost her to cancer last year. And it's weird because when you go on tour, it doesn't matter how old you get, it's like certain people are key to your kind of, your process or something. And she was really key to that. Like, I could call her and just get kind of updates and stuff. And it was neat. So it's different now. You know, I don't have that. But and we have a new band members and great new people. And it's helping. You know, you have a lot of support. We have a lot of support. So this tour feels like the beginning of... It's like a new beginning, kind of. It's a restart, sort of, in a way. It varies, you know what? It varies. But when I... Consistently, I would say Razor Blades is a song that... I can feel it. I know why I wrote it. I know how it came together. And when I play it at night, I can experience it all over again. So I think that song for me is one of the ones that I connect to most, you know. I think, guys will kill me. I think the favorite song I've written is its working title was Submarine, and then it ended up being called Going Under, and it's on the Hurst disc. And the reason I like it is because it's sort of one of those, it's just a song that's out of my element. It's not something that I like. Econoline stuff for me is kind of a natural progression. It's like I can see how the songs will develop, and this song was something that was way out of my element. It was sort of like one of those epic kind of songs from the 70s or something. It had like that real rock feel. It starts with a guitar kind of solo, like it's like so crazy, and just lyrically I liked it. And then the vocals, the way that we structured them, I think, yeah, it just was really well put together, and it's something that I hope to duplicate going forward. But it was a real cool, yeah, it's just neat. If you get a chance to listen to it, yeah, it's called Going Under. Wow. First rock song? You know, there's that song, oh my God. Do I have to admit this? Okay. I think it was like red and yellow seasons changing here. Oh yeah. Who is that? Giving it all I had. Reaching out for love or something, you know that you can feel it. Oh yeah, isn't that Canadian? It's like Prism or somebody. You know she doesn't have to try. It was a high school band, and it wasn't even like it was a school-sanctioned band. So you know it was like the teachers. You know you could practice in, at lunchtime and stuff. So it wasn't even like a real rock band, but kind of a rock band. Yeah. Well. So I had two kids, and I was getting divorced, and the music industry has changed so much that there are times when, as an artist, you get pretty freaked out. It's like, holy crap, like, they're downloading, and the concert revenues are going down, and live revenues are going down. It's just like, whoa. And simultaneously, I was really interested in this, the psychological thing. And I didn't even know really the job existed before I started kind of getting into looking into whether I could go and take it. And somebody mentioned to me that there's this thing called psychiatric nurse, and I'm like, well, what's that? And you work in all these different places and settings. And the more I looked into it, it was like really interesting. So then I started, you have to take, I'd gone to university for 1 year when I first got out of high school, and then I got into rock and roll and never looked back. And always said, like, that, you know, it was kind of silly to put any time into another career, because I thought, well, you know, it's just taking away from your music. So it was always music, music, music. So again, too, like, going to university was sort of betraying what I have always, my beliefs. But it's probably the best thing I did for me as an artist, because changing my perspective, learning new things, pushing myself, testing myself to see if I could do this. I didn't know if I could get through university. I didn't know if I could pass anatomy and physiology. And so I took anatomy and physiology first. I got an A, and I was like, holy cow, like, this is wild. I think I can do this. And I had honors the whole way through university. And yeah, it's crazy cool. It's a crazy cool job. I mean, I advocate for people that are suffering from mental illness. I am the person that stands beside them and says, enough, enough. And man, I'm honored to do that. Honored. I mean, I've always that's the thing. I've always been a helper, and I love people. I love meeting people. I love the fact that that's what I get to do with this job, is to meet different people. And with the psychiatric nursing thing, it's a chance to help people and in a different way. But because of my musical background and all the people that I've met, you know what rock shows are like. There's all kinds of people. I'm able to relate, and I think I have an advantage because of all the stuff I've seen. So. Yeah, I enjoy it a lot, and my clients are always, like, just, oh, I work with some of the greatest people on this planet, I swear. Yeah, no, and I am too. It's like, and I feel like it's something that I will be able to, you know, it works well with the musical thing. It's something that allows me to, when I'm not playing music, I can actually make money and I can contribute, and it also is a way that I can kind of exercise my brain, like, you know, when you're not playing music or you have this downtime, it's hard to do the writing and all these things. And when you're struggling trying to hustle gigs, well, now I can just focus on a con line of music, and then for the rest of the time spend time doing this psychiatric nursing thing and helping people. So it's like you get the best of both worlds. I want to, if I had a special power, what would my special power be? Jesus, I don't know. It's like, you know, I hate suffering. God, if I could stop suffering. I hate suffering, and if I could stop that, I don't know how it would be a special power, but man, if you could just stop. Like, I hate poverty. That would be the thing. Okay, yeah, that's my special power. Anybody in poverty, I could just, like, put money in the bank account, like, bam. And make sure that would be my special part. Wow. I don't know. Gosh, your question's crazy good. A year in my life that I would relive. Jesus. You know, it's weird, but like, there's nothing I really want to go repeat. It's like there's, every year has yin and yang, you know, the good stuff and the bad stuff. And like, it's like, yeah, there's some great stuff. But every time I'm like thinking, you know, oh, I'd like to go back to 1984. It was wonderful. Then you're like, no, it wasn't. So, no, I don't know. Let's just ixnay on that. I'm not going back anywhere. Okay. Yeah. No, it's not. I'm always, like, super tense. They'd say, well, you've been doing this forever. Why are you nervous? But I am nervous. I warm up by, like, I sing, do scales, like, da-da-da-da-da-da, and then pacing, and then I try and think about, okay, visualize, because you finished a song. If it's doing this, then do this. If it's doing this, then do this. It's like all these contingencies you're thinking about, and you walk, and then just hum and walk and hum and warm up your voice. And that's kind of what I do, and then I'm pretty quiet before shows usually, like in my head, just trying to think. I just try and visualize it going well, if that makes sense. Okay, bucket list. I would love to be able to say, like, I want to ride my motorcycle some crazy cool places. And so just a motorcycle vacation would be amazing on the bucket list. I would love to play a show, although I'm nervous about this. It's like, I'd like to play shows with U2 because I'm kind of a fan. But at the same time, you kind of don't know if you want to meet your heroes or the people that you really like.
I'd love to do a show with the Stones. Oh my gosh, that would be fun. And going back to the year thing, I lost my friend Paul Raven, who used to play bass for Killing Joke and stuff. And when I was in LA that one year, when Paul was alive and my friend Bill Kennedy was alive, so that would be like 2000 or 99, I'd take that year back because I miss those guys a lot. I don't know. I mean, I think I could. I like that vibe is a different vibe. It's kind of an organic thing. I don't know. Like, I have a lot of Hurst material, actually, that I have semi-recorded. So, yeah, I mean, I could see myself doing it, but the main focus for me and is Econoline going forward, because, like, the idea of this new record that we're kind of toying with, it kind of fulfills a lot of needs. I would be able to make some social commentary. I can do so through the eyes of this character that we're creating. I can highlight inequities between rich and poor, inequities and injustices between white privilege and those without the white privilege. Have some education around when people say, oh my God, everything has to be so politically correct. Why can't we say this? I'm so sick of people telling me that. It's like, it's not about being politically correct. It's about being human. It's really that simple. I mean, we're all human. We all bleed red blood. We all want the same things. We want to be happy. We want to raise our kids in a safe and, you know, consistently peaceful environment. And how we go about it, obviously, maybe is what the conflict is. I'm not quite sure what goes on in this world. But what I do know is that we're all human. And we're all the same. And we need to remember that. And I'm hoping, yeah. It's just that stuff pisses me off to no end. Anyway, I don't even know how I got on this topic.